the other test relating to lung is hydrostatic test, and the synonyms to hydrostatic test are Raygaard test, flotation test, and the basic principle behind hydrostatic test is upon breathing, both the weight as well as the volume of lung is being increased. And here, begin weight, it is due to the increase in blood flow, and the increase in volume is due to inflow of air. And the specificity of lungs before respiration is 1440 2050, and the specificity of lung after respiration is about 940 to 950. So it means that a respirated lung will float on water when it has been suspended on a water body. The hydrostatic test is performed in four stages. And first stage is of where the whole thoracic plug consisting of both lungs and heart are placed in a bucket of water. And in this stage, where a piece of liver is taken as a control sample, normally in normal condition where a liver sinks usually, but if a liver floats, it indicates there been a presence of putrefaction where the test doesn't have any validity. And the whole thoracic plug consisting of both lungs and heart have been placed in water, and if it floats, it indicates there is a presence of an air and a child has been alive. And if in case the entire plug doesn't float, instead it sinks, it indicates we need to proceed to a stage 2 of hydrostatic test. And in stage 2, where each bronchus is being tied and a lung being served above the ligature, and each lung is being placed in water separately. And if it floats again, it indicates a respiration has taken place and the child was been alive. If in case the either of the lung sunks or sinks into the water, it indicates we need to move to stage 3. Stage 3, wherein the lung has been made into cut into 12 to 20 pieces, and after cutting each pieces, a piece has been taken and it been rolled gently between fingers and thumb and near a ear to hear a crackling crepitant noise, and dip each piece under water and squeeze them between the thumb and finger. And if there been a presence of air, and you can able to notice bubbles that have been escaping under the water, and allow it to float. If they float independently, then it indicates there been a respiration process has taken place. If it sinks, then proceed to next stage of hydrostatic test. And in stage 4, where each piece now taken out of the water, wrapped in the cloth and squeezed by putting a weight. And again, in this stage 4, the important step here being, we are about by keeping a weight and by squeezing them with a piece of cloth or wrap them in a piece of cloth, we are about to remove the expiratory reserve volume and the tidal air. And even though after these measures, where even the residual air still remains within the alveoli, which can't be taken out by any means of any of the maneuvers that has been carried out in stage 4. And the mechanism or the principle of stage 4 is being the residual air which has been within the alveoli will keep the lungs floating. And if there been air respiration has occurred, or there been a born of an alive infant. And if lungs were floating in early stages, it may even occur due to any artifacts in form of any artificial restrictive measures that has been taken during the resuscitative process. And even after these measures, if a piece of lung floats in water, it indicates the fetus has taken a respiration and it has born alive. Reasons for false positive conditions. And here the child does not respire after birth, even though lungs float on hydrostatic test. In other ways, wherein these are artifacts. First and foremost, artifact is artificial inflation. Second is decomposition. And in case of artificial inflation, either by any of the resuscitative measures that has been carried out on saving the life of an infant, where a supportive oxygen, either supplied to by a tube, catheter, cannula that has been passed into trachea, or by mouth-to-mouth respiration. And the second artifact that can occur, wherein fetal lungs, they float even though that there is no respiration has taken place. Where in decomposition, wherein the external features again will be highly indicative, even though wherein lungs, the features like the external appearance, greenish in color, soft in consistency, and able to see appearance of bubbles in larger quantity on the surfaces of the lung, and they are unequal in size, they project considerably from the surfaces, and gas within them can be pushed readily from place to place, and they collapse on pricking. And these are two artifact conditions wherein child did not respire after respiration, after being born, and yet the lungs remains floating on hydrostatic tests. These are false negative conditions wherein child has respired after birth, yet the lung sinks on hydrostatic test. First and foremost is atelectasis, wherein non-expansion of lung and the sequence of events in form of a feeble respiration has occurred in air did not enter the lungs properly, or otherwise air remains up to the level of trachea or the bronchial level, and it doesn't reach the alveoli, and the lungs remain unexpanded, and even though child was alive. Second, obstruction due to presence of alveolar duct membrane, and it causes an obstruction to the entry of air to the alveoli. And disease conditions in form of acute edema, congenital syphilis, pneumonia are the other reasons wherein we can able to see false negative reactions, wherein actually child has respired after birth but lung shrinks during hydrostatic test. And these are conditions wherein hydrostatic test is not at all necessary. First and foremost condition where fetus appears like in a monster. Second, fetus is mummified or being macerated or showing features of decomposition. Then hydrostatic test is not being necessary. The fetus is not viable if it is less than 180 days of intrauterine life. Fourth, wherein stomach contains presence of milk, it suggests there been a breastfeeding has occurred in, and performing hydrostatic tests again in this condition it is not necessary. Fifth, if there been umbilical cord has separated and there is a formation of scar, then again hydrostatic test is not necessary. Thank you so much for your patient listening. If there been any doubts, queries relating to the content of the video, kindly address those issues in comment section below. or otherwise address those issues through any of the social media links provided in description section. Thank you.